Starting and building a business can be a thrill, and for the founding entrepreneur, letting go can be hard. Yet no business is truly successful unless it has a sound succession plan in place. Tom Crowley's back with us with a few tips. He's Senior Vice President of PNC Wealth Management with the Wealth Management and Planning Group. And welcome back. Good to see you again.
Hey, Bill. Good to see you, too.
Yeah, we heard a great story earlier in the program today about Sour Ricin, a company that's over a century old, three generations of family ownership. It's a pretty remarkable story.
They have done a lot of things right. Very good company, a lot of success here in Pennsylvania.
But kind of an unusual story, probably surprising to a lot of people how unusual it really is to have a third generation business.
Yeah, I think the statistics will point that out. And when you think of the word succession, family succession, the word that comes to mind first is transition. So when you've got a family that's in transition and you've got a family involved, that's a transition to the family. Now you've got the family involved. You've got children in the family, maybe children in the family business, maybe children not in the family business. And you've got an owner who's retiring because that's why the transition's happening. And that brings on mortality. And wow, all of a sudden, you've got an owner that's got an awful lot to think about. And the statistics will sort of point out 40% of family-owned businesses don't make it to the second generation. Only 40% do. 13% make it to the next generation, the third generation.
Seriously, so there's like two-thirds fall off from just the first transition and then that much more by the time you try to get it to the grandkids.
And not all of that's about succession planning, but a lot of it is laying that groundwork and dealing with a lot of those issues that will come up.
Well, there's so many moving parts, you really do. Somehow have to find a way to step back from it, and I would think try to view it dispassionately in an environment that's all charged with emotion.
That's right. That's exactly right, and that's always the trick is separating that emotion. So, you know, in the PNC Wealth Management business, a lot of what we do, we talk with our clients constantly about what it is that they're trying to do and how they want to transition their businesses or their lives, and we work with a lot of family-owned businesses. And so, one of the things that we tell them is start now. And stop never. Now that's simple advice, but it's really good advice. And whether they're talking to us or to someone else or talking to the family, that discussion is really healthy. Always be thinking about it, even if you're not close to the event.
Well, that's what I'm wondering. You start having these conversations when somebody hits 60, or should they be thinking about this if they've got a successful business and they're 40?
The answer to that is they should be thinking about that. And one of the things that we suggest is that they assemble a team. And those people on that team would be who you would think with a business owner. They're a lawyer, they're an accountant, hopefully somebody with a valuation background to help them understand the value of their business, their banker, their wealth manager, their insurance professional. Maybe when they have their annual checkup with those folks or semi-annual checkup, that they just get those issues on the table. Maybe they take it up with one of that group, but not all of that group, to help them, to counsel them through. And as I said, often we act as a quarterback in that process. They may ask us as a wealth manager to bring in some of those parties to start those discussions. But that discussion is always necessary.
Yeah, I was fascinated in the Sour Ricin segment that we did, that they had family leadership and then non-family and then family and then non-family and then family. That requires a really sophisticated understanding of the capacity of your family members, of when you need to bring in the outsiders, when the family's ready to go. And that means you got to have some really honest conversations with your children and potentially others.
Clearly the exception to the rule, to go family to non-family back to family. Because you've got a lot of transitions there. Yeah. So they've done a masterful job of that.
You know, I understand in Pennsylvania, the state's actually made it a little easier on family businesses, at least in the way they're taxed, to navigate this transition.
That's right. And it's one of the reasons you want to always be having the discussion, because things change, right? They change. And we've had a very recent change on July 9th, just this summer. There's been a change to the Pennsylvania inheritance tax laws. And we have inserted into the law a $5 million exemption for family-owned businesses. Very specifically for family-owned businesses. And some of the background of that law, quickly, when you look to see whether or not a family-owned business will qualify for an exemption from tax, would be, do they have 50 or less employees? Has the business been in existence for 5 years or more? And will the business continue 7 years or more after the death of the owner? And will it be transitioned to the family? So when you hear those rules, what it really tells you is that it's focused on family-owned businesses and the continuation of them in Pennsylvania.
Well, and how important is that in terms of really making this transition a lot easier? Is that kind of exemption really meaningful when you're talking about turning over a family business to the next generation?
Well, it sure is, because one of the things that comes, that there's many things, many issues that come onto the table, but one of them is the financing or the financial condition of the family business. And if you look in Pennsylvania, our tax is from $1. So Pennsylvania inheritance tax is either somewhere between 4.5% and 15%. So on a $5 million business, that tax could be anywhere from $250,000 to $750,000. It's due 9 months from the date of death. And even though there were exemptions and changes on the federal side a few years ago, there's a $10 million exemption. That exemption did not apply on the Pennsylvania side. They're separate tax systems. So the answer is, yes, it does make a difference.
So yeah, if you don't have a lot of good cash reserves for your business, right, or you don't have an enormous cash flow, cutting a $250,000 check could put some of these small businesses out of business.
That's right, especially if they haven't talked about the other succession issues, like the owner of the business being the business and the goodwill that creates and some of those other transitions. A bill of $250,000 is a lot of money.
That's a lot to think about. The time to start is now. Tom Crowley from PNC, thank you so much.
Thanks,
good to see you again.
You too.
And we'll be back in a minute with a little dollars and cents. Stay with us.